Hey, it's Hayato with Android Central, and after months of nonstop leaks, the Galaxy Note 20 is finally official. And so is the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, and the Galaxy Tab S7, and the Tab S7 Plus, the Galaxy Buds Live, the Galaxy Watch 3. Look, Samsung's been busy, and we've got a lot to talk about, but for this video, let's keep things simple and focus on the Note. With the Galaxy Note 20, Samsung's making a few departures. For one, there's no Plus model this year, just the regular Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra. There's also no small model this year. I was a big fan of last year's Galaxy Note 10, but this time around, the differences between devices revolve more around the features rather than the size. Samsung says the Galaxy Note 20 is for users who want a more accessible Note experience, and sure, maybe compared to the $1,300 for the Note 20 Ultra, $1,000 is technically more accessible, but that's still $1,000. This is an expensive phone, and it's also the first Note in a long time to use a plastic back rather than glass. Now, the mid-frame is still made of metal, which is nice, but when you're paying this much for a phone, plastic probably isn't your first choice, but hey, at least it's less fragile than glass. Of course, the front of the phone is still glass, and the Note 20 is the first in the series to feature a flat display since the Galaxy Note 5. It's roughly the same size as the S20 Plus at 6.7 inches, but the Note 20 is limited to just 1080p and 60Hz. Now that's not the end of the world, but when even the OnePlus Nord at half the price has a 90Hz display, this is a really strange step back, especially considering the similarly priced Galaxy S20 beats out both metrics. It's also worth noting that for your $1,000, the Galaxy Note 20 has less RAM than any of the Galaxy S20 series with 8GB and no microSD expansion. And you know what? Let's just talk about the Note 20 Ultra already. So forget about all of the compromises we just talked about with the Note 20. The Note 20 Ultra is a classic Samsung move, throwing in every high-end feature and spec you could ask for. The back of the phone is proper glass, now in a really nice matte finish that looks especially good in this new Mystic Bronze color, and of course you get microSD expansion, along with 12GB of RAM standard and either 128 or 512GB of internal storage. Both phones are also 5G capable, of course, and you get a Snapdragon 865 Plus processor in either one. The curved 6.9 inch display comes in at Quad HD Plus, just like on the S20 series, and maxes out at 120Hz. You still can't enable both options at the same time, but Samsung is using a dynamic refresh rate this time around, so you're only gonna see 120Hz when you actually need it, which should hopefully cut back on battery drain. Samsung also says the displays on the Note 20 series are 25% brighter than on the Note 10, which should bring them right up to par with the S20 display. And just as expected, both variants of the Note 20 will ship with Android 10 out of the box, along with the latest version of Samsung's One UI 2.5. So the Note 20 Ultra has an enormous new camera housing, and that's because it's fitted with the same 108 megapixel sensor as the S20 Ultra. Now, to combat the focusing issues the S20 Ultra had, the Note has a new laser autofocus system that you can see just to the right of the sensor. The wide angle is the same as on the S20 Ultra as well, but the Note 20 Ultra has a new 12 megapixel, 1 micron telephoto sensor with a native 5x zoom. This reduced resolution means that it probably won't do as well when it comes to digital and hybrid zoom, and Samsung has capped the Note 20 Ultra's extended range at 50x versus 100x on the S20 Ultra, but the tighter native focal length combined with the larger individual pixels means that 5x shots should look much better than on the S20 Ultra. In other words, Samsung is choosing pragmatism this year over marketing bling, and I think that's great, but of course we're gonna have to wait until we actually have the device before we can comment on image quality. As for the regular Note 20, you're looking at exactly the same camera layout as on the S20, with the same phase detect autofocus in place. Now, it wouldn't be a Note without the S Pen, so let's talk about that. First off, they've moved the S Pen to the left side of the phone, which is pretty inconvenient if you're right-handed, but presumably there's just no room inside with the giant new camera housings. Samsung says it's reduced latency in the S Pen by 40%, and it's added some new gesture controls for system-wide navigation, that's home, back, and recents, and things like screen capture. Of course, as always, you get 4,096 levels of pressure sensitivity with the S Pen, and it should last up to 24 hours outside of its charging silo in the phone. If you're interested in picking up a Galaxy Note 20 or Note 20 Ultra, pre-orders go live first thing tomorrow, August 6th at 12:01 a.m. Eastern. If you pre-order the Note 20, you get a $100 gift card to Samsung.com, and if you grab the Note 20 Ultra, that gets bumped up to $150. That's almost enough to cover the cost of the Galaxy Buds Live, or you can pick yourself up a nice case or battery pack. Both phones officially go on sale August 21st. Make sure you stick around in the meantime to see all of our continued coverage on Samsung's Unpacked announcements. We've got a very busy schedule ahead of us. Thanks as always for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, stay safe and check out some of our awesome written coverage over at AndroidCentral.com. We'll see you next time.